बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलामुअलैकुम किड्स एंड अ वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू यू ऑल। होप यू आर सेफ एंड डूइंग वेल एंड एंजॉइंग योर वेकेशंस एट योर होम। टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज़ द स्टोरीज फ्रॉम कुरान एंड आवर सेकंड स्टोरी इज़ अबाउट हज़रत इब्राहिम अलैहिस्सलाम। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। हज़रत इब्राहिम अलैहिस्सलाम। Long, long ago, many people in a town worshipped stone. They used to make and sell these stones they worshipped. They didn't worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent a prophet to tell them the truth. His name was Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam. Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam was born in the kingdom of Babylon long, long time ago. He was blessed with wisdom. Even he was a child, and this made him very, very special. The prophet born in that time when people used to worship stone idols, stars and moons. Hazrat Ibrahim al-Islam father was a sculptor, and he made the stone idols with his own hands. Ibrahim loved his family very much. He told his family to worship Allah, but his father didn't want to listen to him and kept on worshiping stone. Many other people also didn't listen to Ibrahim alayhi salam. So Ibrahim thought of an idea to teach his family and the other people that worshipping stone is useless. When all of the people went to a festival, Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam broke all the idols with an axe. He broke all the idols, but he left the biggest idol and put the axe near that idol. When all the people returned, they saw all their stones, idol broken. They asked Ibrahim, "Who did this?" He said, "Why don't you ask the biggest idol? He should know." The people said, "But the idols can't talk." Then Ibrahim replied, "How can you worship something that cannot speak or do anything?" Hazrat Ibrahim al-Islam wanted the people to realize that the stone idols cannot speak and they cannot do anything. So how can they be your God? But the people still didn't listen. They became even more angry with Ibrahim al-Islam. Nimrud, the king of Iraq, ordered to put Hazrat Ibrahim al-Islam into a huge fire. So the people made a huge fire and they wanted to put Ibrahim al-Islam in it. Then they threw him in the fire. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to show the people he could do anything. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the fire to be cool and turn into flowers and do not hurt Ibrahim al-Islam. All the people were amazed that the fire was not hurting Ibrahim alayhislam, but they still didn't believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they still worship stones. The message of this story is that you should trust Allah and Allah will always help you. Thank you. Student, I have already uploaded the worksheet about this chapter and I hope that you will listen to this story carefully and will solve this worksheet by yourself. Thank you.